Beautiful.
Absolutely beautiful.
So beautiful. So beautiful.
Just majestic animals, you know.
Stunning. It's just that connection you get with Lynn.
Yeah.
She's so gentle.
Yeah,
and you just, and the power.
And you just wonder what they're thinking, you know? Right? What?
I think they like being scratched.
And they like water too. They love water. They play in the water all the time. You let them. Right?
Well, when I was in Surin, the guy was telling me it was like 400 litres a day.
I believe it, yeah. I mean, the food, I know they eat like 200, 250 kilograms.
A day.
A day, each, yeah.
Are
you going to take some pictures of her?
Yep.
Take pictures of her.
It's all right.
She'll like you.
Come on.
She'll like you.
Look.
See? It's good. I'm happy. Whenever they're flapping their ears, that means they're happy. So. It's when they start flaring their ears, man, you got to watch out because it's when they're angry.
One, two, three.
You're okay. Go on.
Slowly.
Stunning.
No problem.
They're all very happy, though. All these elephants are really happy, aren't they? You can see them.
Because you see them moving around a lot, it's because we're here.
We're here. They got excited because of the food.
They get excited with someone new.
Oh, look at this one.
That's why you notice when I started petting this one, she stopped swinging her head mostly. Yeah. For the most part, not always. You know, but same like this one. They do that when they're anxious.
Really?
But if we went up and started petting her and talking to her, she'd stop.
Yeah. Well, the thing is, it's like anything. They just want attention, don't
they? Yeah. They're very sociable, you know. They like the attention.
Bye-bye.
Trust me, if she didn't want me around her, it wouldn't be too hard to get rid of me.
Thank you.
next best thing is to open, get, take these camps and try and improve the standards, try and you know, talk with the mahouts, because what, yes, you know, they're doing things that have been done with elephants for hundreds if not thousands of years.
Yes.
So there's a huge, as you know, cultural component to this. And luckily, yes, my wife, who's Thai, is able to be a great go-between and communicator.
Yes.
Because us as foreigners just walking in off the streets and saying, hey, we're here to help. Well, we've seen how, you know, that's like a missionary, you know, you see what can happen if it's not done properly.
Gotcha.
So luckily we've made really good relationships with these people, and they've gotten to know us, that they know our intentions are just to help. We're not here to judge, and we're not here to change anything, at least now.
Okay.
You know, we do want to work on improving the treatment of them, but not that it's bad now, but you know, we would love to have them roam more free than they are now.
Okay.
But the camps in this area are all in a major city. So just like having a dog in your yard not having a fence, you can't just let that dog run free
No.
in the city, because it's going to run out in traffic. Well, same Yeah. with these animals. There's a major freeway.
Yep.
We just came off of coming here, right?
Yes.
What's it, a block down the road?
Yes.
Another camp that we worked with, has got a, it's right on a major road, Sukhumvit.
Yes.
In Jumpian. So, you know, we have to consider all these things, and it's not an easy solution
No.
to just take 60,000 and put them out in the jungle. It's not realistic. It's not fair to the elephants, and it's just not a realistic solution. So we're doing the best we can, given our resources, and I think, you know, just providing a consistent source of food, supplies, and medical care is job one right now.
I talked to my wife. She's telling me, like, 20 years ago, monkeys used to be in every village. They used to be everywhere. Now there's no monkeys hardly anywhere now.
I believe it.
And the same with elephants. The elephants can't feed themselves in the jungle.
Right.
There's not enough food.
There's not enough jungle, yeah.
Yeah, there's not enough food there to feed them.
Yeah, so, you know, we're doing, you know, people got to understand the context. When looking at this situation, we're here on the ground. We know the cultural components. We know the geographical and logistical components.
Yes.
Someone poking in from YouTube or Twitter doesn't see all that.
No.
You know, so us trying to sell these NFTs now, and raising money for this, and also we're starting a conservation tour company we will be able to take people behind the scenes. If you buy an NFT from us,
yes,
if you ever come here, you can exchange that NFT for a behind the scenes tour like you're getting today.
Yes.
And we'll take them.
Yeah, because you just can't come here, can you?
No.
So if somebody wants to come here, if they contact me, or I'll put your contact details
in
if you want, whatever you prefer, and then that way they can arrange for you to come
sure.
here.
Yep.
And also the NFTs, which obviously a lot of people don't really understand, but the NFTs, it's like artwork you're selling, isn't it?
Right,
it's like,
right.
They're like JPEGs you're selling, is
exactly,
it?
Exactly, yeah. They're all, we have 9,999 total. The first 100 are hand-drawn. The team's got an awesome artist from South America.
Okay.
He hand-draws all those, enters it into the computer, and then there's a computer program that takes the traits of those 100 and computer-generates the remaining 900,000.
And I can
9,000.
And I can put those pictures on. Yeah, I can.
Yeah, you can see the XRP.
Hello.
How are you?
Yeah, right.
Doing
you?
YouTube.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Sure. So they can pull up go to thexrpherd.com.
Okay.
And you can find out all about the project. You can see our teams, see pictures. Mm-hmm. I'm available for any chatting. You want to get a hold of me, Digital Nomad Investor. .com, just one big word, Digital Nomad Investor. I'm sorry, @gmail.com.
Okay.
And, you know, we can walk you through the project. I can refer you to the technical people if you're having any issues with buying the NFTs with XRP. But yeah, they're really cool custom NFTs. Each one's different.
Yeah.
And then, like I said, you can just hold on to that, or you can exchange it for a voucher, or you want to sell it to someone that's coming here.
Yes.
And they want to use it for a voucher for a free behind the, not a free, but for a behind the scenes tour.
Yes.
We'll take them on that. I've done that before. I just did one 2 weeks ago with somebody that came from the States, and he's coming back. He went to Phuket and he's the States. He said, I'm coming back in about 8 weeks. He's like, I want another tour. So I'm like, great.
Fantastic. You know? When you first released the NFTs, What did you turn over in the first week or so?
The first, yeah, they've been out a little over a week. And we sold about US dollars over $10,000.
Well, that's fantastic, yeah, because that is going to really help
feed
these beautiful, beautiful, I'm not even going to call them animals because they're not, they're our brothers and sisters,
yeah,
really.
Yeah, that's a good way to put it, yeah. Yeah, so part of the money will go towards feeding them, then the other part of the money will go towards us creating this conservation tourist company that I was just describing,
yes,
about bringing people here. And also in Phuket, that's the other city where my other partner is.
Okay.
And the founder of the NFT company, they founded it, and then they recruited me, and I joined, and I'm partners with them now. So basically, I'm now doing with them what I've been doing since 2020 with these elephant camps here in Pattaya, but now I'm doing it in a business format where we're able to, you know, monetize a solution to this problem, which is really the key. And we're adding utility to NFTs.
Yes.
You know, the NFTs are not just a picture.
No.
For our NFTs, now they're worth, they have some value.
Yes.
Apart and above.
Yes.
From the artwork itself. So.
Yes. But it's just amazing, isn't it, when you're seeing these beautiful,
yeah,
beautiful brothers and sisters.
There's 30 of them here. 30 of them. This is the biggest one we've worked with. We're trying to work out something with this place to open it back up.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah. Through our company, we're working with. It just takes money, you know. Just takes money. I've been.
Well, this can't be cheap to reopen anyway. This can't be cheap to. All these elephants and all this food, all this water. My God, it's costing a fortune.
Yeah. Well, the rent alone is 60,000 baht a month, which is $2,000 US.
Okay.
And that's COVID prices. So the owner discounted it because you have usually with these elephant camps, how the business structure goes is you have the landowner. And then he rents the land to a businessman.
Yes.
Who then recruits these mahouts that own the elephants.
Okay.
So you have three entities. So when I say business owner, it's only he's like the guy in the middle that, you know, doesn't own the elephants.
Okay.
And that's why they stopped.
Okay.
That's why they stopped providing money for food, because
yes,
they're not their elephants. You know, so that's why these folks. So
this is live stream, yeah?
Yeah. So people donate. There's the contact information for the bank down there.
Okay.
Phone number. And then they donate, and then she'll feed the donated
food
basket right to the elephant live, so the people can watch with their donation at work.
So this is Thai people doing. This is Thai people doing this.
Thai, yeah. Here, watch. Can I do? Hot spot, right? Okay, my phone. Okay. This one. No, no, one. Okay. Two. Okay. Tom, you want one?
Oh, so you just give.
And you get one elephant, I get one elephant.
Yeah.
Sure. Call in. Donate. You don't. My dad?
Oh.
They don't like my chop? Oh, teeth. Cannot. Oh, okay.
Can I eat this, yeah? Beautiful. And these are just beautiful creatures, you know? So she's doing all this on live stream. Is this mainly Thai people going on this?
Yeah, Thai for Thai, yeah.
Really?
Yeah, believe it or not. They do a good job. We taught one of the camps how to do that.
Okay.
And they started, doing really well with it.
Okay.
And then I started advertising on English-speaking Facebook pages to
yes,
get people, because I'm in some elephant groups on Facebook.
Of course.
And
XRP and, so, and elephants.
Yeah, exactly. So getting a recruit, getting more recruited people to the live stream and donating more. So anyway, that works.
It's just so nice you can come here and help them,
I love it. I mean, like I said, I get so much out of it myself. It's always a privilege. Yay!
Is it good, Anna?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah?
You know, in these camps here, they got, you know, they walk the elephants, they wash them.
Yeah.
You know, we, you know, me partnering with this company, the XRPherd.com, has allowed us to monetize a solution to this problem, which is taking to the next level how much help that we can bring to these elephant camps. Now, I every now and then we'll get the argument that, well, why can't you just set them free? And you really can't. You can't just take these animals that have been captive and just throw them out, you know, in a jungle somewhere. Like any wild animal that's been domesticated, that's not fair to the elephant. So what we're trying to do is just provide as much help of getting a consistent source of food for them. That's really the key, is a consistent source of food. All those other issues are another argument.
Yeah.
You know, we're not even at that stage yet. We're still trying to get them consistent food.
Yes.
And that's the important thing. And we agree, we want to, you know, there are sanctuaries where you can set them free at, and they got hundreds of acres of land, and there's still food provided, medical care provided, and but it takes a lot of money. You know, it takes, just to buy one of these and relocate it is $60,000 US. That's to buy it, and then that doesn't even include the relocation cost.
Hey, good job. Good job.
She's singing. She's singing. That's really good.